doctor by profession. In fact, I worked as a medical advisor or the chief medical doctor of the national team of the Czech Republic for 3 years. And the more I worked, the more questions came up to me and the more questions I began to ask. And it progressively became very difficult to be a doctor and getting to know the other side of the sport of bodybuilding. So eventually I quit my profession. But the question that I have for you, that he has for you, George, is whether you consult your know-how and your applications with the medical staff that you know, or whether you just go by home.
Well, first of all, I am married to a medical director. My wife, she's the head of one of the largest hospitals in New York. And I always consult with her. I always read. I always up to date. I'm partner. You know, I work with WebMD. I'm always there. I learn stuff. So it's not, like I said, it doesn't come overnight. The stuff I have is not just, you know, like, you can't just bring stuff out of your mind, you know. The main thing you as a doctor, you know, that it's not about, you know, quantity, it's about quality. It's what I mean by that, you know, most of the young generation, they get an idea that as soon as you get in the gym, I'm just going to have to start enhancing myself and take that drug and stuff. It's wrong. Well, for an example, Kai Greene, he turned professional bodybuilder without using anything. And he didn't do anything, you know, and he turned professional bodybuilder. And everybody's like, wow, how did he gain, you know, 30 kilos in a couple of years? Because he never did anything before. And then when he needed it, he started using a little stuff. So, you know, the most important thing is, you know, your question to me is, where I get my knowledge. Of course I gotta read books, and of course I gotta consult with all my friends. There are so many doctors, so many things. Because the main thing, and this is what I always, you know, health before anything, because it doesn't matter. The first thing we started working, me and Kai, I said, you know, if you become Mr. Olympia and then you're on dialysis, it's not gonna do you any good. He goes, absolutely not, I don't want that. And that's how I like to work with the people, that they put health before bodybuilding. And unfortunately, all the young generation, they don't care. They just go and use everything, and it's wrong. You need to stop. You need to be smart. You need to ask. If you don't know, you need to ask the people around you, like yourself, doctor. You know some stuff that it's good, and you know some stuff is bad. So we need to be ambassador and show the people that it's not. Bodybuilding is not just about taking drugs. It's about working hard, sleeping. Like I said, it's suffering. You know, when your friends are partying, you're actually taking your protein, eating, you're counting your amino acids and your carbs. That's why we make, you know, successful people. Not because, you know, you just want to go and party and do this stuff.
I hope somebody asks me how I can remember that all the
charts. You're very smart.
And then translate. Znamená odpověď. Pokusím se jednak jedný zodpovědět tu otázku ještě jednou v českém jazyce. V první řadě George má manželku, která je ředitelka, je doktorka. Je ředitelka jedné z největších nemocnic v New Yorku. A nejenom, že věci konzultuje s ní, ale konzultuje i s celou řadou profesionálů, lékařů v oboru nebo mimo obor jako takový. A to v podstatě přivedlo, nebo obecně se bavíme o tom, že řada z mladých nebo mladších adeptů nebo kulturistů jako takových, takže má představu o tom, že kulturistika je o konzumaci nebo užívání celé řady a hlavně velkých objemů různých farmaceutických látek. Že první, co udělají, že přijdou do tělocvičny, najednou chtějí nárůst a chtějí být velký a myslí si, že to je o té chemii. A ve skutečnosti ta kulturistika o tom zdaleka není. Ta je o tvrdé práci, a je to o detailu a je to o tom, jak člověk přistupuje k tréninku, k té správné výživě. Například řada lidí nebo mladých lidí dneska přijde v pátek domů nebo kdykoliv přijde domů a jde na počítač nebo jde na nějakou party, jde upařit, jak se říká. A kulturista nejde pařit, protože ten si musí udělat to správné jídlo, musí dodržovat pitný režim a podobně. A v každém případě, co George ještě chtěl dál dodat, je, že ta kulturistika je, že je to o tom, aby ten člověk měl nastavené ty hranice, aby měl ten správně nastavený i žebříček hodnot. Že to není o tom, aby za každou cenu, když začal pracovat například s Kai Greenem, že mu říká Kai, že toto není o to, aby si šel, aby si vyhrál titul mistra Olympie a další měsíce si strávil na dialýze. To v žádném případě nechci. A ta klíčová message, ta zpráva, kterou chtěl říct všem, že například i Kai Green, když než se stal profesionálem, tak v žádném případě nepoužíval žádný zakázaný látky nebo žádný chemikálie, které mu pomohly s tím rozvojem. A dost možná i proto v momentě, kdy se stal profesionálem, tak potom pro něj nebyl problém přibrat řádově 30 kg čistých svalovin. Protože tvrdě trénoval, poctivě trénoval, poctivě se stravoval a to tělo potom nebylo potřebované a bylo připravené k tomu, aby dál potom rostlo.
Hello, regards for your success. I have two questions. The first is, what's your opinion for the making the water out for the last week for the new category in your physique? And what do you think, what shape you should make for this category, more lift or not? The second is, what do you think for training with high weights? And for the aerobic, do you like the aerobic or not? For and the last question is, what is the normal dose for you for using insulin and glucagon?
Well, so bad, you don't have to say anything, you don't have to say anything, you don't have
to. Okay, well, you know, to me, it doesn't matter what you're training for, physique, bikini, whatever. When you're in the gym, you got to give it 100%. The only difference is, you know, like a couple people actually, I was at the show, an IFBB show, and I was helping Mark Anthony. You guys know he's Mr. Olympia and physique. I was helping him to do a show in Pittsburgh just like a month ago. And everybody's like, oh my God, you know, why Mark is winning? The other guy's bigger and stuff. And Mr. Mannion told him, you know, the head of the whole organization, he said, you know, that's why we have physique. You want to be big, we have a different thing called bodybuilder. You can do that. So if we're talking about ripped, yes, fine. You got to be ripped. You got to be in shape. You know, because what I like about my guys, they get in real good shape. So when they stand on the stage, they don't have to push or nothing. They have nice look in line, beautiful, but not necessarily big. So there's no reason for you to use tons of stuff, you know, to become, you know, a physique champion. You know, you gotta take it easy. And when you talk about insulin stuff, absolutely not. I don't like insulin, not even on bodybuilders, so why are we gonna use it for physique? You know? I think that's the question, right? Anything else?
I think it was kinda combined with growth hormone and insulin. I was actually wondering that myself.
We'll go back to that. Now I just wanna answer the gentleman there. So did you understand me?
Or did you understand you?
What do you think for the using weights? The weight should be more
high weights. Like I said, there is no high rep stuff. You know,
in the training,
just train as hard as a bodybuilder. There's no difference. Yeah. You know,
five, six times
for me. I like, you know, for your upper body, you should always do between 8 to 12. This is almost every, even the Berkeley research show, the 8 to 12, you can really fire up your muscles perfectly. Anything less than 8 is too heavy. You're not building muscles. You become a power lifter and you hurt your joints and stuff. And anything more than 12 is too light. So in order for you to activate the muscles, I'll keep it between 8 to 12 on your upper body and 15 plus on your lower body.
And how many times a week do you think it's okay to make aerobics? Every day or only?
This is the difference between other people. A lot of people, they do aerobic to lose weight. You know, I don't do aerobic to lose weight. If anybody works with me, they know the most I ever let anybody do aerobic is maybe 40 minutes. You know, this is if they're out of shape. You know, you remember, right? What were the 25 minutes and you get in an amazing shape, right?
Maximum 30.
Yeah, so I don't really like too much aerobic. I use aerobic actually to gain weight in the off-season. I use aerobic more, you know, in the off-season than I use it, you know, for pre-contest. Because pre-contest, you're unlimited calorie, you got to be careful. If you do too much cardio, you lose your fullness, you lose your upper. So I don't really like that. I like, you know, I like you to... You know, like I always say, if you want to call yourself a bodybuilder or physique or whatever, and you walk around in the off season and you can't see your abs, don't call yourself a bodybuilder. Don't call yourself a physique because you're not. Because you're only worrying about how much pizza you're going to eat and cake and ice cream. This is not what champions do, you know what I mean? So if you're in shape all year around, it will be like a piece of cake getting ready for a show. And if you want to be champion, you have to be different than the rest. That's why I said, you know, anybody can go eat whatever they want, and, but that's why they're not sitting here. That's why they're not on the stage with us. You know, that's why they make fun of us. You know, when they see somebody who's a champion, you know, they say, ah, this guy, he's this and this, because they're jealous and they're envying us because not everybody can be like us. It takes a lot of dedication. This is the hardest sport. I don't care what anybody does. I think bodybuilding and physique or whatever, this is the hardest sport because this is, you know, it's every day. It's not like, you know, golfing or boxing, you get ready for 4 or 5 weeks and you're ready. No, this is every day. Whatever you put in your mouth is going to show on the stage.